As we saw, the mathematical model for the truss is based on minimization of the potential energy. To understand how the potential energy is calculated, let's first consider a spring since it's easiest to understand. And then we'll extend that understanding to a bar and then to a truss composed of multiple bars. To look at the spring, I'll go to this graphic here. Okay, so that's a spring or a caricature of it. And this is in its unextended state. And then I apply a force F to it. And under the influence of that force, it's going to extend. And let's say it extends like that. So I have my force F here. And let's say that's its equilibrium state. So I'll abbreviate equilibrium as EQBM. Let's say the spring has, under the effect of the force F, it's extended by an amount equal to d. In the equilibrium approach, you would look at this blob here, okay, this guy here, and you would say, there's a force F acting on it in the horizontal direction, and the spring is pulling back on that blob by an amount equal to kd, d being the extension and k being the spring constant. It's a property of the spring. And force balance indicates that at equilibrium, kd should be equal to f or d equal to f over k. So if I know what the force is and what the spring constant is, I can predict what the extension of the spring is. That's the equilibrium approach for the spring. We get the same answer if we use the potential energy approach. And to see how that works, let me plot here. So I'll make a plot of the extension of the spring versus the force in the spring. Now, initially, the spring doesn't have any extension, and so its force is zero. And then it gets extended to an amount d, and at that point, the force in the spring is kd. And we'll assume that the force in the spring goes from zero to kd in a linear fashion. These are called linear springs. Okay. And the area under this force extension curve gives you the work that you can get out of the spring. It's kind of the and that's related to the potential energy of the spring. So you would have to look at this area, and that gives you the potential energy stored in the spring. But that's not the whole story. You have to look at the external force. Now, the external force has moved in the direction in which it's applied, and so there's a loss of potential energy because the external force has done work on the spring. To see what that loss in potential energy is, okay, let me go to another plot. So here again, now I'm looking at the applied force versus extension, okay? And the extension again is the same, d, but we assume that that external force is applied instantaneously, so it stays constant. Okay, it stays something like that, and the area under that curve is that. So to find the potential energy, the net potential energy, and this is usually denoted as pi, so I'll say pi is equal to the potential energy, stored in the spring, which is half kd squared. That's the area of this. And then you have to subtract out the work, the loss in potential of the external force, which is, so this is F, so it's F times d. By the way, for the longest time, I didn't understand where that half comes about, whereas why there is no half over here. And this argument hopefully, shows you how, and that cleared it up in my mind. Now, if I plot, we love these plots, don't we? So if I plot, so if I do another plot of pi, the potential energy versus the extension, you'll get a parabola. And where the potential energy is minimum, that's the equilibrium position. Okay? So to find that in the potential energy approach, what you would do is you would differentiate this with respect to d. So you'd say d pi over dd. Okay, that looks weird. Not the best of notations, but hopefully you get the idea. And you set that to zero, and you'll get this point. And you can verify that that will give you d equal to f over k, which is the same result as that. So that gives you a sense, conceptually, of how you can get the same result from the potential energy approach and the equilibrium approach. Next, let's take a look at how this approach can be extended to a bar.